As of December 24th of 2023, on this Christmas Eve, there are currently 51 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. This list includes a volcano on every single continent, with one example that recently joined this list being the Poas volcano in Costa Rica. Poas is well known for its highly acidic crater lake, which means when its fairly frequent phreatic or phreatomagmatic eruptions occur, that an explosive reaction is triggered. Poas has erupted more than 36 times in the last century, with its latest eruption beginning on December 16th and producing at least 4 phreatic explosions in the days since. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, only 6 days after the alert level was raised at the twin Lewotobi volcanoes, this system finally produced an explosive volcanic eruption. This event, which generated pyroclastic flows, was the first eruption to occur on the island of Flores since 2008. Elsewhere, on the island of Java, the alert level was raised at a volcano famed for producing a deafening roar when it erupts, a volcano known as Raung. Raung happens to translate to the word roar. Yet, this week's top story relates to an impressive volcanic eruption that occurred in Iceland. As, at 10:17 p.m. local time on December 18th, a new volcanic eruption began at the Reykjanes Volcano. The eruption started unexpectedly, sending towering lava fountains to a height of more than 150 meters as an expanding fissure figuratively unzipped until a 4-kilometer-long stretch of land was simultaneously erupting at a rate of 400 cubic meters per second. Yet, almost as rapidly as the eruption began, it soon rapidly decreased in intensity at a rate that seemingly surprised everyone. While it took the shortest eruption of Fairbanks 78 hours to lose half of its rate of lava output, it instead only took 10 hours for the same to occur at Reykjanes. 24 hours into the eruption, lava fusion had decreased to only 6.25% of its original output, and by hour 48, this figure had decreased by another 84%. Then, only 49 hours in, the eruption ended. In total, between 18 and 33 million cubic meters of lava erupted and covered an area of 4.76 square kilometers. However, magma is once again building at the 5-kilometer depth magma chamber 1.1 kilometers south of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, meaning it is probably not a question of if but when this volcano will erupt again. This magma is once again expected to eventually run to the east into the dike which just erupted, which, in my opinion, will occur sometime between January 4th and February 15th of 2024. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the island of Flores was the site of its first volcanic eruption since the Egon volcano erupted in 2008. This new eruption occurred at the Laki-Laki cone of the Lewotobi volcano, where at 7:14 a.m. local time on December 23rd, a powerful explosion occurred. The initial explosion sent a plume of ash to a height of 3,000 meters, but since superheated material was ejected from the active crater, it fell back to the ground and descended the cone's northern flank as a pyroclastic flow. This pyroclastic flow scorched an estimated 1 square kilometer of the ground, reaching up to 3.39 kilometers north of the volcano. Over the next 24 minutes, an additional 23 explosions occurred, ejecting minor amounts of ash. While no more explosions have occurred since that sequence, prior eruptions of this very volcano suggest that more explosions will occur over the next several weeks to months. My personal opinion is that the current 2-kilometer exclusion zone is insufficient based on the number of people who live nearby and feel that it should be expanded to at least 4 kilometers from Laki-Laki's summit, if not more. Elsewhere in Indonesia, the alert level of the Raung volcano, which is famous for its occasional loud strombolian or volcanic eruptions, was raised from 1 to 2 on December 18th. This change was due to a greatly increased rate of earthquakes in the preceding days at shallow depths where fluids could represent magmatic fluids, magma, or both. As a result, the exclusion zone was expanded from 500 meters from the edge of Raung's large crater to 3,000 meters from its edge in all directions. It may only now be a matter of time before Raung erupts again, where it is most likely to produce a moderately explosive eruption similar to what was witnessed during 2020. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on December 23rd of 2023. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Dunk Cameron, for supporting this channel.